Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to look at how you can transfer motions from iClone to Unreal Engine 5 with a single click. You can use iClone to transfer a variety of motions to any target, including both characters and props. If you're not familiar with Unreal Live Link plugin yet, please check out our beginner tutorials for tips on installation and basic operation. For this tutorial, you'll need to ensure that you have both Live Link and the Auto Setup plugins installed. If properly installed, you'll see them in the Unreal toolbar at the top and in the plugins as well. Let's start off in iClone by opening up the Unreal Live Link panel and ensuring we're in the Transfer tab. There are two main methods for transferring, and we're going to explore the scene mode first. Notice that the transfer list corresponds to those items listed in the Scene Manager. In this case, I'm going to start by only selecting our character Kevin along with the current camera. Before I activate the transfer, let's take a look at the transfer settings. Place Assets in Scene is on by default, as is Delete Hidden Mesh, which can help to avoid inner meshes poking through outer layers of your character's clothing when animating in Unreal and also reduce poly count. Subdivision Mesh means it will export the subdivided mesh that you've set in iClone. This relates to when you enable the Smooth Mesh feature in the Modify panel, which creates a more refined mesh surface. You can determine the level of mesh smoothing using the sliders here. Once that's all prepared, let's click on the Transfer File button to bring the character and camera over to our Unreal scene. This transfers everything over, including morph data as well as material and shader settings, which are all taken care of via the Auto Setup plugin, saving you huge amounts of time when working between the two programs. Okay, let's ensure that Live Link is active in Unreal and get ready to put it into action. In iClone, I'm going to switch to the Link tab where you can find the IP port settings. These should be consistent with those found in the Unreal Live Link panel. I'll only leave the camera and character activated in iClone, then proceed to Unreal to enable, and finally click Activate Link in iClone. You now have a real-time preview link activated between the two programs. We can switch to the active camera in Unreal to get a consistent camera angle. Let's explore this by applying a motion to our character in iClone. Once we do in playback, you can see the preview in both programs in real time. The results look great, right down to the materials and small animation details. Because previously we only set the character mesh into Unreal, there will only be a binding pose in the motion folder for this motion that we just applied to our character. Every iClone character imported will have the same folder structure created in Unreal. Let's take a look at a quick and easy way to transfer character motions to Unreal now. Let's begin by opening up our timeline in iClone and using the function at the top to restrict our project length to that of the clip we have selected. Then, over in our Transfer tab, I'll switch over to Motion Mode, which only allows the transfer of motions. If we select Range in the Export Range section, it will default to our project length, which we just defined in the timeline. Then, I'll select Transfer File again at the bottom. Once transfer is complete, you'll see a new animation asset appear in the character's motion folder in Unreal. If we give it a preview, we can see that all of the motion data was transferred over, including all of the blend shape animation that make up the subtle facial expressions. In this next scenario, let's look at how we can utilize iClone's motion clip blending feature for quick motion matching. If I apply these two motions one after the other, there is a sharp transition between them that we can smooth out by blending the two clips together using the transition area gizmos. After a couple of seconds of tweaking, you can see that they now blend seamlessly. In this case, I'll multi-select both clips and use the same function from the timeline to set the project length. I'll repeat the process in the Unreal Live Link panel, again ensuring that we're in motion mode and our range is defined properly. In Unreal, the two clips will be baked together into a single motion and placed in the same folder as the others. It's just as easy to replace your character's appearance or outfits in Unreal as well. Here I have a Kevin with a different sweater and sunglasses. In the Unreal Live Link settings, you'll want to ensure here that you have Scene Mode selected and that the character name is consistent as well. Once you do that and transfer file, the model in Unreal will be updated. You'll still be able to use all of the same motions and everything, as the rig structure remains the same. Okay, lastly, let's look at how you can transfer prop motions into Unreal with Live Link. What I'm doing here with this helicopter is applying a couple of different perform motions from its embedded menu. If you're interested, you can find this helicopter prop as part of a bundle in our content store from developer Antarius. In addition to the perform animations, I can also apply a transform animation to change the position of my helicopter. I'll start by simply transferring over the helicopter model first using scene mode, and it will appear in our Unreal project. To import in our prop animation in Unreal, we first need to set up a level sequence as our main timeline. In the sequence folder, right-click and go to animation, then level sequence. Let's open up the sequence we just created, add a track, and go up to sequencer and choose our helicopter prop. We also want to add the skeletal mesh component subtrack by selecting it from the plus track button on our helicopter track. After that, from the skeletal mesh component track, we're going to add another subtrack for animation mode using the same method, and then choose Use Animation Asset to utilize one of the perform animations we brought in. When you select this, sometimes it will cause the prop position to be offset, in which case you can just reset the transform values back to zero from the details panel. I'll then click on the plus animation button, which will allow me to choose from any of those perform motions that I applied to my prop in iClone. I can apply this door opening animation and define the playback length. After that, you'll be able to see the helicopter transform position change, complete with our door opening animation playing back in Unreal. That's it for this tutorial, guys. Please check out our YouTube channel and Learning Center for more tutorials on the Unreal pipeline, and I'll see you in the next video.